Greetings to all of you. Myself, Dr. Nikita Suresh Aravi, faculty from Management Studies Department from Jambu Mahana Thakur College of Arts, Commerce and Science, Autonomous Singapore. So in previous lecture, we have discussed about corporate finance meaning definitions and what are the importance. So in today's lecture, we are going to learn more about corporate finance and its principles. So let us have some recap. What is corporate finance? Defining it, a corporate finance is a financial activity as it relates to the money and how the corporation raises money from the public, from the society, or you can say from the shareholders. And they utilize that funds into the business operation. The corporate finance basically focuses on maximizing the shareholders' wealth, you can say the shareholders' value, through long-term financing and short-term financing, and utilizing it properly by using various strategies. Now let us focus more on principles of corporate finance. There are some major principles for running the elements of corporate finance in this. First is the financing activity, second is investment principle, third is principle of dividend payment, fourth is principle of shareholder value maximization, next is principle of return and risk relationship, then profitability and liquidity optimization principles, next is principle of working capital requirement and internal control principle. Now let us discuss it one by one. What is financing principle? Majorly the corporate finance job is being handled by a chartered accountant or a financial manager. This person is very much important in dealing with all the financial decisions into the company. This financial manager deals with the monetary resources, inflow and outflow of cash utilized in the business operation. So first talking about financing principle majorly focuses on how you are managing the fund allocation into the business. Means how the fund is being raised by the company at a very much low cost. Means many companies provide their finance facilities to the shareholders. Shareholders come and invest their money into the business and charges interest rate on that. That interest rate should be minimum, and so that company has to pay less amount of returns to the company, to the shareholders. So similarly, they are managing on how to raise the finance at a very low cost in an optimum value so that the funds are properly channelized into the business operation and there is a less amount of a cost of capital utilized. Cost of capital is basically cost to the capital. Cost which can be in the terms of an EMI, installment, or can be the interest rate, which is to be paid on the debt. Debt in the sense shareholders are giving money to the business and that money is being utilized. So company is actually borrowing the debt from the shareholders or the other participants. So to minimize that risk, the financing activity is important. Next is principle is investment principle. Investment principle comes where the company decides how much amount of investment is to be made into the financial assets, into the fixed assets, into the any kind of a property, so that they can earn maximum amount of return. Maximum amount of return in the terms of income. So they are minimizing their risk and maximizing their returns. Next, the principle is principle of dividend payment. Dividends are being issued to the preference shareholders or the equity shareholders. If the company has acquired fund or taken loan or have shareholders have given money to the business, so that money can be in the form of a different sources of fund. So, it is the duty of the company or the organization, if they have borrowed the debt or they are enjoying the equity fund, how much amount of dividend is to be paid according to their percentage involvement of the share investment into their company. So, these dividend is to be paid to the equity shareholders or the other stockholders. Next is principle of working capital management. Working capital is the major part of a company, where company look into below the day-to-day operations of their manufacturing, managing, office expenses, selling and distribution, finance expense, and going higher to the profit allocation. So this day-to-day operation of the business required short-term financing on day-to-day basis. The financial manager decides how to manage the funds properly. So it is a very tough job and it requires a good amount of a planning which deals with cash inflow and outflow both. So it requires long-term financing as well as short-term financing. Now next principle focuses on principle of shareholder value maximization. Shareholder value maximization means what? If the shareholder feel wealthful to invest in the company, their goodwill and their value increases, as well as if the company also thinks that they are providing good amount of dividend to the shareholder, they will definitely come back again to your company to invest more. So hence, indirectly, it is the company role to decide how you are going to maximize the value of the shareholder, and in turn, they are maximizing their own company's wealth into the market. Next principle is principle of return and risk. So this principle focuses on return and risk relationship between the investment. So it actually intended that if there is a high risk, there is a high return, vice versa. If low risk, then low return. The company majorly focuses on maximizing the return by utilizing the fund into the right direction, or you can say the diversification of fund into the investment is such done that risk is to be mitigated, risk is to be optimally utilized, or risk is to be minimized to obtain the greater value of the amount of investment, or you can say the maximum return on the investment is to be made. Lastly, we focus on the principle of profitability and liquidation option, means liquidity optimization. Profitability means how you are generating profits into the company, how you are retaining back profit to the company into the cash or cash equivalent, and liquidity means how much amount of cash is being available to utilize at the n numbers of funds or operation going on into the business. So it is basically leads to proper planning of necessary optimization of the profitability and liquidity to run the business smoothly and efficiently. Lastly, we deal with the internal control principle. Internal control principle is the major task of the any of the financial manager. Here, he deals with the control of an efficient resources to be utilized into the organization, and if finance manager works efficiently so that the management can internally control all such operations and minimizes the risk of extra fund wastage or utilizing it to the proper channel and retaining the a good amount of profit into the business and giving high amount of dividends to the shareholder by increasing their own wealth into the market. So these are all the principles of corporate finance. Thank you so much.